actual stone from the actual cat that inspired that character. That's correct.
Murray Ball took a lot of inspiration from his own life on his farm in Gisborne. So the tough character of Horse was from his real life, and it also made it into the comic. A perfect example of, you know, art and life coming together and just everyone loving it. Was he a stray that just showed up one day?
When we bought the house in the 70s,
yeah.
The house came with some house cows and it came with some sheep and a billy goat. And Horse was the resident cat.
So he adopted the Ball family.
He did.
The thing we loved about Horse in Foot Rot Flats, the strip, was that his no-nonsense, never take a backward step. Was the real cat like that?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, he was a very hard-case cat. Strong and then also loving on the other side of the coin.
And why was he called Horse?
He was a majestic size, this cat. When he wandered in, my brother said, he's as big as a horse.
Yeah.
And the name sort of stuck.
Isn't
and then
that right?
It became somewhat immortalised when Dad put it in his cartoons. Horse used to tag along a lot with Dad. He was really quite wounded when Horse died.
As I spoke before about the characters on strip all having an element of me in them, I have to exclude Horse when I say that, because Horse has had the independence and the strength that unfortunately I don't possess. I do like Horse, but Horse was had a character way beyond me. And I had a very strong admiration for him, I don't know why.
One of the cool things about Foot Rot Flats was how it took elements of New Zealand culture and centred it around here, and it was something we could all really connect to.
That's right.
After do you remember the tattoos?
Yes, I thought they were very funny. Did you think they were funny? Did you think they were funny?
Yeah, I think so.
Grossed 2.5 million at the New Zealand box office and 4.5 million in Australia. If we had those numbers now, that would still be amazing. That's quite a legacy that your father has left. How does that make you feel as a son?
Oh, it's terrific. You know, yeah, the legacy's important, but the legacy of my dad goes above and beyond his cartooning. He was a great father as well, and he loved his country, and he loved his people, and he loved his cat.
And of course, his work still carries on. It's still sold.
It is.
Around the world.
Yes, it is. Well, thank you for remembering it.
But obviously, grave robbing is never something to be encouraged. But if it's contributing to an item that is classed as a national treasure that helps us tell a story that's significant to the people of New Zealand, I think that's one of the few circumstances where grave robbing is allowed. But it should be discouraged, generally speaking.
As a nation,
this virus does not respect borders.
When COVID hit New Zealand, few of us had any idea of how it would impact our lives.
No one wants loss of life, and that's why we are all presently self-isolating to try and prevent that as much as we can.
Hi, Colleen. Can you tell me a bit about what you've got here?
It's Jacinta and Ashley Manfield, and it's a press conference made up
look
of
at them.
Recycling.
So this is the 1 p.m. press conference that everyone tuned into.
Yeah, the iconic 1 p.m. press conference.
Framed their lives around. Cinder and Ashley became these kind of like godlike figures in people's lives.
No one wants loss of life, and that's why we are all presently self-isolating to try and prevent that as much as we can.
It was this weird, surreal world, and you're suddenly locked in your house, and they just became this like point of normality. When one of them wasn't there, I really didn't like it. I was like, oh, where's Ashley today?
So what inspired you to make this object?
Part of it was to get some sort of therapy. So my mum had leukemia, and she was sort of all right. I actually had tickets booked to go and see her, but just as lockdown was sort of kicking in.
From 11:59 p.m. tonight, we will close our border to any non-residents and citizens attempting to travel.
She got pneumonia. She passed away before. And it was obviously a deeply sad time. The bit that was really hard was not getting home for a last hug, a last goodbye. Everyone saw the people on the news that couldn't get to loved ones. And I was definitely one of those. I mean, it was a piece that was created for fun, but for me, privately, it was definitely part of a healing